Welcome to the QE2.
She's the most famous ocean liner in the world.
So much history and romance.
Back in the day, she was the place to be seen.
There was David Bowie, there was Nelson Mandela. Where would that happen in life?
Now she has a new home in Dubai.
QE2 is older than Dubai itself.
And a new life as a luxury hotel.
It's scary every day. You don't know what's coming around the corner.
Forward. No, back.
700 oysters. This doesn't get people going, then nothing will.
Honestly, that was wow.
Chip ahoy.
She's a little bit of Britain with a lot of royal heritage.
This is the room where I met Her Majesty.
It does sort of smack you around the head and say you're in part of Britain.
Roast dinner. That tastes like home.
Oh.
Crumbles, bread and butter pudding, anything that can go with custard.
I think it's wonderful. It's out in Dubai. It looks enormous.
Fighting her corner in the world's toughest hotel market.
Every second in Dubai, there's something new opening up.
Wow.
We have to make sure that she makes money.
But with a multi-million pound refurb underway.
Pressure's certainly on. Time is against us.
These lights, this means a lot to a lot of people.
How many days we've got?
One more day. That's a lot of pressure, yeah.
It's been a mammoth restoration job.
And a new team at the helm.
Get this right!
Guys, come on! Get things moving!
Someone's head's gonna roll.
Oh, Lord.
Probably my head's gonna roll.
Get ready for the madness that's about to happen.
Will it be sink or swim for the QE2, the world's most luxurious floating hotel? After four decades at sea, the QE2 is embarking on a new journey as a floating hotel in Dubai.
Hi, good afternoon, ma'am. How are you doing? Good, checking in.
Now permanently docked, staff have spent over 2 years transforming her from flagship cruise liner to successful hotel.
Your room is ready, captain's club room with balcony.
It's a daily challenge to make it all work. And today, it's the busiest day of the week, Friday. It's the start of the weekend in Dubai. And here, Friday isn't Friday without brunch.
There's a massive trend for brunches in Dubai, and it's just pure indulgence. Everything that you could imagine.
Every Friday, the hotel welcomes 250 guests, many of them expats hungry for a taste of home, for a British-style Sunday lunch.
Yorkshire pudding, your roast potato, your beef, and your chicken.
Crumbles, bread and butter pudding, sponges, steamed sponges, anything that can go with custard.
The British here, they love the Yorkshire pudding very much. It looks beautiful. Wow. Oh, right. Real British Yorkshire pudding.
While staff keep the hotel's 8 restaurants and bars and 200-plus rooms up and running, behind the scenes, the ship's renovation rumbles on. The project is only halfway through and has already cost over $100 million. CEO Hamza Mustafa is making sure the investment pays off.
Yeah, I get to have free food here.
Whilst also managing guests' expectations.
The QE2 is a ship first, and some of our guests forget that they're on a ship. Hold on, we're walking into the corridor and it looks like it's tilting on one side. And yes, it is tilting. You are on the ship. Now we have completely changed the concept of what is the QE2. When it comes to lighting, when it comes to plumbing, when it comes to wiring, I've had to change all the infrastructure of the ship to modernize her. People want to come to the ship to celebrate what the ship was. So it's constantly been the struggle between the future and the past, the future and the past. Do I stick to what she's famous for, or do I change and gamble with new concepts that can work or might not work?
And this week, it's crunch time for the ship's biggest renovation gamble so far. The reopening of the most important restaurant on board, the Queen's Grill. Almost at the end of a 7-month makeover, the grill was once the brightest jewel in the QE2 crown and a favourite hangout of the rich and famous.
We hope you will enjoy this sort of one-hour tour.
These days, it's a treasure trove of tall tales for Head of Tours Peter.
The Queen's Grill in the day was your first class. There is a story that once some passenger said, yes, I'd like elephant, please, and they said, would you like African or Indian? I'm sure it isn't true, but I mean, that, you know, that gives you an idea of the lengths they would go. So it was wonderful, and the Queen's Grill itself stood for a lot. When I first heard it was being refurbished, I was a little sad because I thought some of the history may be going.
With so much of the ship's heritage at stake, it's up to designer Chris to steer a narrow course between past and present.
You walk into the Q2, it's in a different world. And that's the magic, I think.
Oh, wow, that's nice. Perfect.
Whatever you add on has to emphasise this.
Nick, I think I like it. Beautiful, the patina's lovely. It's the size a little bit small, I think. Yeah. But good thing we got the other one.
Dubai is a very modern city. And I think this is why we want to bring this heritage to our guests.
This way a bit.
It's an ongoing process, but attention to detail is everything.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Love it. Let's crack on with something else.
And for CEO Hamza, getting those details right could make or break the Queen's Grill and the future of the hotel.
I do get criticized at times that we've changed names or I've moved art pieces around or I've moved a chair. So we've always had to find the balance between keeping the enthusiast happy and to keep your corporate customer happy to make the ship work.
But bringing the Queen's Grill up to date isn't just new seating and a lick of paint. Executive Chef Dino's giving the food a major makeover too.
Queen's Grill originally was a very, very fine dining venue. When the ship was sailing, the waiting list for passengers booking the Queen's Grill could sometimes stretch to 12 to 16, 18 months. We need to change that entirely, where this becomes a walk-in off the street venue, but very, very, very good quality, quintessentially British. Out.
Start frying the fritters, put on the pass.
The grill started serving fancy food to the well-heeled in the early 70s. And Dino's got a book of old menus to remind him what the food was like.
This book captures what the Queen's Grill was all about in the day. Lue de mer, pommes de terre nouvelles, is basically sea bass vegetables and new potatoes. The concept that we're going with now is we're making it more funky, we're making it more fun, we're making it more casual.
Dino's new menu swaps the heavy classic staples for lighter, simpler dishes.
Caramelized cauliflower puree on the bottle, yeah?
But less stodge on the plate doesn't mean less pressure for Dino's 60-plus chefs.
I need that blender, that's it. I need that blender for 5 minutes. What is the big deal for that?
I think in every kitchen, the pressure is really, really high at all times, but you know what? That's why we're here. We like it. The adrenaline rush.
Get everything fast.
It's the same as jumping off a plane, I guess, sometimes.
Stress is not the word. I had black hair before you arrived.
And today, it's a race against time.
Are you in control, time-wise?
Yeah.
Pressure's certainly on. Time is against us.
Because after 3 months of work, Dino's bosses will be dropping in later for a final tasting of the new dishes.
Today will be a menu tasting kitchen side, 28, 30 different dishes. It's very important to get it bang on. If the boss likes it, then all good. If he doesn't like it, I'm the next kebab.
After 40 years at sea, the QE2's now got to make it as a hotel in ultra-competitive Dubai. It's an important week on board as the ship reopens its most renowned restaurant, the Queen's Grill. And down in the kitchen...
Brush, 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 put it fast.
Stress is reaching fever pitch for executive chef Dino and his crew.
How long do you need? I want plating done.
There's sea salt, sea salt.
I think stress comes hand in hand with this job. More so when you've got the opening of a restaurant. It just puts the cream on top of the cake and then the cherry on top of that.
With the Queen's Grill launch night looming, Dino's new menu faces its final hurdle.
Service.
A tasting with General Manager Yunal and Director of Food and Beverage, Grant.
Altogether, we've done about 6 or 7 different tastings. So the chefs have been cooking off their rocker right now. But it's just to make sure that we understand what we're serving and we get the product right.
Chef Prasad, who's in charge of the new restaurant, is hoping they've now perfected their dishes. But even before the first forkful...
How long before we can start?
The bosses are less than impressed.
Enough, 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 enough. OK, we don't have the hours and the days to wait.
Because plating up's taking too long.
Minimum 25 seconds per plate. Too much going on.
Imagine you have 120 guests in at the same time. How is that feasible?
With food finally making it onto the plate.
Let's eat.
Dino and the bigwigs now have to sample more than 30 dishes.
Oh, really?
The bosses are after a fresher, funkier take on the traditional Queen's Grill menu. So, what's the verdict?
You are going back into sophistication of fine dining. You have to go back more into the casual, easy to do, and something not...
Easy to do is the key.
Easy to
but
do.
With the Queen's Grill touch, simplify.
We moved from the stiffness of fine dining to the more relaxing, actually elegant, casual dining to please a wider range of our customers.
So for opening night, chefs need to drop old-fashioned formality and serve up less fussy food.
This is nice.
But an unusual haggis and haddock-themed starter...
Who would think, huh? Haggis and haddock.
...is ticking everyone's boxes.
You know I hate haggis. I would order this.
There's no place in the UAE that is serving anything close to this.
This is, would be a signature for us.
Sexy, sexy, sexy. That's flavour personified, really. It's always nerve-wracking. It's always stressful. It's going to be a challenge.
Dubai has over 100 five-star hotels. But for designer Chris, none can match the vintage glamour aboard the ship.
Dubai is a brand-new car. Beautiful, but everybody appreciates with it when you switch on the engine of an old Rolls-Royce. That element, that is what I like to reflect.
Today, as usual, beds are being changed, ready to check in new guests to the 224 rooms currently open. But for the hotel to stay at the top of the Dubai market, it also needs to offer exclusive five-star suites for high-end guests. After a complete makeover, the two refurbed royal suites are almost ready to go.
Quite a bit to do still.
But as he goes for a final inspection with project manager Nina, the decor's not floating Chris's boat.
We really gave that yacht feeling to the rooms, and there were a few things that was not right.
The joinery will go back for repainting because
the type of paint is not what we really coat it. Yeah, it scratches very easily.
Little quirky elements that it wasn't working for me.
The colour moquet, if it's fully, sort of, completely gloss, like this one here.
Guests will pay top dollar for these rooms. Getting them right is vital if the hotel is to be competitive.
But look, look, the scratches here.
But there's a problem with the suite centrepiece, a custom-made bar.
This one here, we need to make sure that, see, it's hitting the step.
It's got a kind of an old-fashioned design to it. You really want to feel that it's almost been there forever.
The way it's coming together, I'm not too pleased.
Chris is so unhappy, he's sending some furniture back to the manufacturer for alterations. But with the clock ticking on the makeover, will his gamble pay off?
Sometimes you have to take that call, but nevertheless, you never know. It might go wrong and there's another delay and hopefully fingers crossed.
The royal suites and restaurants aren't the only thing on board getting a makeover. So are some of its staff.
Hi, Bilal, how are you? Good. I believe my uniform's here, is that right?
Yes. Head of tours, Peter, is one of only two crew members who were on the ship when she was sailing.
Now, that instantly feels great. It'll be like the full captain's uniform, you know. We are the oldest hotel in Dubai now. With that comes along years of rich history. And indeed, that's what our passengers who come on now want to know about so much. When you have a uniform like this, it makes you feel different. It's lovely.
Since the ship relaunched as a hotel, it's welcomed 600,000 guests on board. But below all the hustle and bustle are secret spaces that guests never get to see.
Lift is one of the original lifts, mainly for back-of-house use. Ceiling's not very high, can't put so many chairs and tables inside, so it makes the job a little bit more difficult. But she's an old girl, and we make her work.
Five of the lower decks are out of bounds to passengers, and behind closed doors, there are plenty of surprises.
The lights on.
This area holds thousands of pieces of crockery, cutlery and utensils.
We are currently now on deck 7 of the ship, so where we are is actually underwater. It's one of the original refrigerated stores of the ship, but because of its size, it helps us nowadays with the storage of items.
Exactly. Yes, this is the one that we were looking for. Look at that.
20% of the stock in here is original tableware that came with the ship.
We came onto the ship and the amount of equipment was spectacular. We were walking around with our phone torches all over the place, scavenging, looking for everything. These are the original plates, so the Cunard logo, the single gold line, fine bone china, Wedgwood. Here you're working with real historic items that are older than me, not saying that I'm historical, but, you know, it's just unique.
It's the ship's uniqueness that attracts thousands of guests on board.
We'd like to extend a very warm welcome to you to QE2 this afternoon.
And in reception, head of tours Peter, now modelling his new uniform, is starting his first tour of the day.
Without further ado, let's go and start the ship. Ship ahoy.
Meanwhile, out on the quayside, there's an important delivery. The new furniture for the unfinished royal suites.
We need to position it properly so it goes straight up to the second deck suite, OK?
The replacement bedhead is too big to be carried through the ship, so it needs to be craned to the top deck.
The guys are waiting now to get the hook coming down.
A nerve-wracking manoeuvre for project manager Nina.
It depends on the weather conditions. Up there, the wind is sometimes much different than to what we have here downstairs. So we would see. Crane is starting. The crane cannot maneuver in a centimeter range. As long as you don't bang it against the ship wall, there should be no issue. It's a little bit like these crane games on the fun fair, where you have to place things or where you have to grab things, and it needs to be kind of accurate.
But it isn't today's only unusual sight on the ship. Up on quarterdeck.
Yeah, good.
A fashion shoot's hit the runway.
On you go.
A British fashion brand have flown in from the UK to photograph their new cruisewear line on the ship.
Lovely.
It's absolutely beautiful because the light's gorgeous and you've got this real sort of sense of old world charm here. The styling is amazing for our clothes as well, so it's just this really lovely sense of nostalgia that it creates.
And marketing director Katie wants to impress them, especially head of the fashion shoot, Lorraine.
Lorraine used to be my boss. She was my first official boss. I know how meticulous she likes everything, so I just want to make sure that she's happy. When your former boss comes back, you're always going to be a little bit, is it right? Is it perfect?
Good morning.
But sailing through a fashion shoot in a busy hotel...
Come through.
...has its challenges.
It's OK, no bother.
So we're getting quite a few people walking through. Some of them are just walking through and then others are just sort of, you know, hanging back a bit.
Thank you.
And there's an even bigger challenge when the crew step off board.
It's a big crane, there's a big crane there.
We are with the crane.
We can't have a crane in the bloody shop, can we?
Nina's furniture hoisting is making life difficult for photographer Martin.
The plan was to shoot exactly where the crane is. Fingers crossed, the crane moves fast. Get the crane out of there and get our shot.
Automatic doors in front of us, sir.
But there's now a tour group going out on deck.
Tell them downstairs. They can prepare the crate, but wait until the tourists are gone.
Which means for safety reasons, furniture hoisting's got to stop.
Obviously, nobody should ever walk underneath any item being craned up.
Right, go back a bit.
With the light changing fast and a real risk of missing their best shot, the fashion crew come up with plan B.
Just there.
It was a bit tricky, but we found a really good angle that'll work.
OK, we're over here, guys. We're over here. I can't move the camera. Over here. Lovely. Good there. Hold there. Good there. Gorgeous there. That is amazing. OK, relax, guys. Keep yourselves covered.
Sorted for now, but they must get essential sunset shots from the bow of the boat, which is still being painted.
Do we have 5 minutes to get it off here?
On board, Nina's still waiting for the final piece of furniture. The bar for the royal suites.
We have only certain time slots when we can get the minibar up, so now we're a little bit restricted, which is obviously making it kind of exciting. And I'm actually getting another call from hotel operations.
Hi, winner. Thank you so much. All right, we will crate now everything up. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. All right, that was the news. I can go ahead with the craning.
The tour group's now well out of harm's way.
All right, let's get those guys moving.
And the Royal Suite Bar is en route.
Crane is starting. Guys, come on! Get things moving! Anything can happen anytime, and I need to very quickly react to spontaneous things coming up. It's a challenging balancing act. We just need to always, obviously, accommodate it and smile.
With the furniture in, Nina's now got an anxious wait for senior designer Chris's verdict.
This is much better. This fits much more into the picture of this room. I mean, from the transport and everything, we need to look at like aligning all the hinges and everything properly. But it's really cool.
Up on the top deck, the grill, opening in just a few days, is still being worked on. And designer-in-chief Chris is feeling the heat.
This means a lot to a lot of people. This means a lot to Dubai as well. It's a mammoth job.
And it's a mammoth job that may not finish in time, because the Queen's Grill Lounge, known as the Captain's Bar, still isn't ready.
Curtains, lights, missing.
So Chris and project manager Nina...
We have a lot of little shadows here.
...are checking on what needs to be done to hit their deadline.
A lot of areas are either stained or cracked. They have tried to touch it up, but you can see the touch-up.
I like it to be aligned, actually. We have a site condition, which is a low ceiling, everything very close, so attention to detail is everything.
There's already a lot to put right in a short space of time.
The bar counter. We need to get your marble specialist here.
And now Nina's found a major flaw.
We have, unfortunately, a crack running through. But this crack, obviously, is a very visible one, and it's a front of house, so...
The 30-foot marble bar is the star attraction.
And the contractor, obviously, if they cannot repair it to our standards, they're going to need to replace it.
It's early afternoon aboard Hotel QE2. Check-in time.
So your room is actually ready for you to check in now.
And assistant manager Anthea's in charge.
So far, we've had 38 people check in, and it is only 2:14.
It's getting busy.
How are you guys doing today? Checking in?
Yes, we are.
I have to go walk around. I have to go make sure everything is running smoothly, which is hard on the feet.
Good, enjoy.
Yeah, he did win a prize for smiling.
No one's smiling much in the Queen's Grill kitchen. The revamped restaurant's opening tonight.
Can you give me one more, please?
So it's D-Day for Executive Chef Dino's new menu.
It's a massive push to be ready. It's all hands on deck.
Everyone wants to do all they can to make tonight a success.
Rush, 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 put it fast.
And Director of Food and Beverage Grant has hit on just the thing to give this evening high-class zing.
It seems weak.
Top-notch cocktails.
Maybe something a little bit more kick behind it will work.
Laced with royal connections.
Could we maybe try the dry martini? We've actually selected that because of Princess Elizabeth, whose favourite drink this was. Yep.
This is a Queen's Cruise Liner, so we need to take that royal element as well. So we've made it martini. From what I understand and what I've heard, the Queen has one every day. Mm. Ah, it's good. It's good. It's good.
Fresh raspberry and fresh blackberry.
Okay, this is the Empress Kiss.
Empress Kiss.
Another classic of our original QE2. Important for us to get this right here.
The USP of the QE2 is very simply heritage. The names that have visited the ship, I get goosebumps thinking about it. So the cocktails that we want to present, we've tried to focus a little bit on the new, on what we really want to be, but not forgetting what we were as well.
Old classics have been blinged up with British blackberries sprayed with gold.
Very nice, elegant.
Or topped with liquid nitrogen.
Edible bubble.
This is Dubai, after all.
So we just pop it and that's it. Wow. Honestly, that was wow. This could be something very, very nice. My only concern, guys,
getting that right and being able to serve that to them makes me a little bit nervous. Yes, but this is what I think we need to do. The cocktails for us are an idea of what we want to be perceived as. Does it make it challenging? Yes, it does. Does it make it easy? No, it doesn't. But does it make it rewarding at the end of the night? I have no doubt it will be. Thanks for the work, huh? We'll speak soon. Thanks.
Out on deck, marketing director Katie's cooked up a crazy caper to create an instant buzz about the hotel. She wants high-wire athletes to film their stunts on board in the hope that the video will go viral and bookings will increase. There's just one snag.
If the safety team don't agree, it's game over.
To keep her high-octane plan on track, Katie's got to convince head of safety Mike.
Let me tell you what they want to do, first of all, before you start freaking out, or maybe freaking out more. They're going to slide down the funnel. They'll jump over and swing down a rope. La la, easy. And then they will rig the bridge wing.
Yeah, okay.
And they will swing all around. How does that sound?
Scary, very, very scary.
But... yeah?
While Katie's grand plan to attract the under 30s hangs in the balance, CEO Hamza's dead set on saving the ship's past.
We're now heading to the main control room.
And even areas below deck, never seen by guests, are on his list to preserve.
This was the heart of the ship. If the bridge was the brain, this was the heart. All the controls of the ship was from this area.
The QE2 was designed in an era before software. It was actually designed by hand, men with calculators, with a lot of pens in their pockets. And a testament to who they were, she's in pretty good shape.
From here, they would monitor all the 9 engines that the ship had, and they would get commands from the bridge. This is the main propulsion lever. Full steam ahead, dead stop. Effectively, with these 2 tiny levers, you drove this mammoth of a vessel.
The new hotel's electricity supply and aircon are monitored from here. But what is surprising is that the ship's massive engine room is still intact.
So this is it, one of our 9 engines. When these engines were fired up, they would roar.
The ship's engines, each the size of a double-decker bus, generated 95 megawatts of power, enough to light up a city like Southampton.
It was one of the fastest vessels ever to sail the seas. She sailed from Southampton to New York in 4 days. The QE2 represents what made British engineering famous.
You know, when I come and see this, I think, how was she during her heyday? How many people worked down here to keep these engines running smoothly?
But Hamza's decision to keep the engines in place is driven more by practicality than sentiment.
We actually looked at removing all the engines and using this area for ballrooms. However, by removing these engines, you'd mess up the naval engineering of the ship because of the weight displacement. So we decided to preserve this area the way it is. And in the future, hopefully one day, once we've cleaned it, to allow people to come down here to reminisce how it was.
9 decks above the engine room, marketing director Katie's high-wire athletes have arrived.
3, 2, 1, action.
She wants to bring the ship to a younger audience by filming stunts on board in the hope that they'll go viral and drive up bookings.
To do these quirky stunts, I think they get us a lot of attention online.
Despite his concerns, safety officer Mike has greenlit filming. And head of tours Peter has bagged a starring role as captain.
Brian. Oh, my goodness, great. On my ship, I mean, really, what's going on? Incredible. I mean, loved it. Never before have I seen that on here, never. Fantastic.
Fun it may be, but it's also risky. A zipwire's being rigged from the iconic red funnel for the day's trickiest stunt.
The ship gives us a unique playground to work on. For her age, in pretty good shape.
This daredevil feat should deliver the high adrenaline impact that Katie is after.
This is going to be great.
Three, two, one, action.
That wasn't part of the plan.
I re-grabbed it, which is a silly idea, and then it just burnt straight through the glove and through all levels of my skin to the flesh.
As the last shots are captured without any more incidents, the crew get everything they need in the can. Fingers crossed it'll have the attention-grabbing impact Katie wants to pull in the younger crowd. But one 20-something on board today is already a QE2 fan. Now 23, Thomas and his family holidayed on the ship when he was little. He's even got home videos of himself on board as a child.
As a family, we spent many lazy afternoons in the Mediterranean, sitting down here. It's sort of coming home, in a way, coming home to a second home. A second home we had each summer.
There's one place on the ship that Thomas is keen to see again, the bridge.
As a crew, we didn't come up very often at all. So
okay.
Not unless we're getting a turning off or a meeting.
And head of tours Peter has agreed to show him around.
So here we are then, Thomas. How long since you've been?
Sir, 11 and a half years.
Oh, my goodness me. Sir. Gracious.
Gosh. It's very good to be back. Favourite place on the ship.
That's fantastic. This was the hub of the whole thing, the wheelhouse we are in now, of course, isn't it? You know.
The tank.
The tank, the nickname, yeah.
So two bridge visits, 2005 and 2008.
Gosh.
Back then, I couldn't see over the helm at all. I was down here.
Oh, yes, yes.
And the first time, we were going 28 and a half knots through the Bay of Biscay.
So you steered the ship?
Well, it was locked, but there was like slight movement.
Sort of.
This photo was taken actually in 2005.
Oh, goodness me.
At the wheel.
Oh, gosh, right here. Okay. Priceless that you can't actually see over. I mean, but lovely, and you look so happy there.
Yes.
You know?
There's a real buzz about being on the bridge of a ship.
You know, as soon as you stepped on, it didn't matter where you went. That was superfluous. You were in
the ship. The ship was the destination.
Exactly.
QE2 has inspired me to try and have a career at sea, hopefully be a quartermaster.
Young Thomas isn't the only one who's been inspired by the ship. Another guest, Reuben, on board today with his children, has dramatic memories of her sailing days.
Of course, being a teenager at school, it was a dream to go on a vessel such as this. And I remember the night we were sailing just out of the Bahamas, and as the vessel left the Bahamas, she had a complete power failure. A vessel the size of this, a complete power failure. There was just the emergency lighting. Everybody was in the casino, didn't know what to do. And I remember just staring out of the porthole, watching the waves going by in disbelief. And as a consequence of that, I wanted to know more as to why and why it happened. Because of my time on board, I decided to become a marine engineer and naval architect, and have been a marine surveyor ever since, doing inspections on vessels such as the QE2.
Reuben now lives in Dubai and helped welcome the ship to her new home when she arrived here in 2008.
My company was given the responsibility to tow the vessel around Dubai. So we took the QE2 from where she was in Port Rashid and we towed her to Dubai Dry Docks, you can just see in the distance, where she was repaired. We then towed her from here back to Dubai. So she's always been a part of me, I suppose. From early days even till now.
But for the ship to secure her future in the competitive Dubai hotel market, she needs to keep impressing. After the earlier drama of a crane in shot,
come in a wee bit now, that's it, stay there.
Katie's fashion shoot is back on track.
It's great.
OMG.
But it's about to hit a last-minute problem out on deck.
There's a photo shoot happening down here. Someone's head's gonna roll. I always wanted to say that. It's not really. It's probably my head's gonna roll. Is it down there?
It's the only chance to get sunset shots from the bow.
We have a chute on the bow. This is the way to get down to the bow. And it's got paint all over it. The bow downstairs not wet. Can't
How long do you think we've got? It's what,
20 minutes?
With time running out.
This is insane.
Katie's come up with a cunning plan to exit via a door on the lower deck.
You had to operate that, Katie.
Easier said than done.
I'll just get someone to open this, so bear with me.
We're supposed to get out through this way, but it seems to be locked. So Katie's had to go and find somebody to see if we can actually get out the door.
But even with extra muscle, the fashion shoot's still stuck.
Can't get this bloody door opened.
I couldn't have planned this better.
Thank you.
With no time to lose...
Oh, look at that. You are strong.
They're out on deck.
Oh, you made it.
That's very dramatic.
That's gorgeous.
And the fashion shoot's back in business.
It's brilliant, yeah.
Good. That's it.
Yay!
It's a hectic day done and dusted for Katie and the fashion crew. There's just hours to go before the reopening of the Queen's Grill. And with the cracked marble bar being put to rights and last-minute snagging finished in the dining room...
I'm always excited. I'm always worried as well, but fingers crossed.
It's finally ready to go. Relaunching the ship's most famous restaurant is a big deal.
The salmon needs to go in faster. As soon as it's cold, get it in.
Chef.
So tonight, the stakes couldn't be higher.
The Queen's Grill was always the restaurant that everybody wanted to go to, that you would book 2 years in advance to get a seat. It's a key part, if not the biggest key to success for the QE2.
No, it's not ready. It's not ready.
In the kitchen, it's the final frantic prep.
Chef, are we ready?
Huh?
Are we ready? Guys, we have to get on the ball, huh?
No, I'm not...
Wait. When it's not successful, it's stressful and horrible. So tonight's a disaster. I'll just remove my apron and leave.
Tempers are getting frayed behind the scenes.
Ready. Need to finish now. Table 5 is confirmed or not confirmed?
It's confirmed.
No, it's not.
If they don't come, they don't come. It's okay. An a-la-carte okay. Menu.
Fine.
What do we do?
Get it right.
And success tonight depends on more than just the food.
We just do a quick uniform check.
Director of Food and Beverage, Grant, is checking everything's up to scratch out in the restaurant.
Felix, Ty, ready to go, please. Look, at the end of the day, we've got a job to do. Ty, my team know that I will drive and I will push. Just the name badge missing, please. In order to make things work on the ship, we need to be forceful to get things done. Just one more thing, please, yeah? The big watch, get something more discreet. An eye for detail is always key in our industry. I mean, that's what sets your regular hotels apart from your really high-end hotels.
And now that Grant has sorted out the last-minute touches, the restaurant is finally ready for guests. And Peter gets the chance for a sneak preview.
My goodness. It's lovely to be back in the Queen's Grill. Somewhere, of course, I could never afford as a passenger to eat. Well, now, this does bring back memories. Gosh, this piano. This, I'm not sure if this is the one, but Elton John certainly did play a piano on board the QE2. And I'm going to have actually sit down. It's a Steinway, no less. And what can we say other than eat your heart out, Sir Elton? I wasn't sure, if you want the truth, when I was told a Queen's Grill was being redone. I thought, oh, but I put my toys back in my pram and I thought, no, wait. One word describes it. One word, outstanding.
Oh, Gonald's Pot.
Gonald's Pot, darling.
Up in the refurbished Royal Suites, it's also a dash to the finish line for project manager Nina.
The fingerprints need to be off, and I think we're about to be there.
With the new furniture in, the rooms are finally ready for VIP guests. And Chris is on his way for final sign-off.
This is the moment of truth. They're not ready now. They're never going to be ready.
Good morning.
Oh, finally. Brilliant.
Yeah, do you like it?
Yeah, finally.
Maybe coffee machine aligned straight, but that's me. Good, very good.
There's the ability for us to do lots of different things and really get the guest excited. You have to make sure that it's flawless.
It was good, but now it's so much better. The bar setup is really, really good. I'm quite proud just to leave that mark. It feels like an old friend that I work with, and I get to know her more and more, and as good friends, you grow the love for them. For me, it's very personal. Well done, guys.
Cheers.
Well done.
Thanks.
Another major renovation job ticked off the list. And up on boat deck...
Whatever they ask, we can give.
The new Queen's Grill is in for a big evening.
If I'm saying 1 minute, 15 seconds for a plating of a dish, every dish has to be 1 minute, 15 seconds. It cannot take more. I cannot wait 25 minutes for 40 plates to come out, because that is what's coming.
After 7 months, the hotel's flagship restaurant is ready to welcome guests again.
Isn't that they're coming? They're here. They're here.
But will the funky menu, swish cocktails, and expensive refurb hit the right note?
Being on a ship has a sort of quite an intimate atmosphere. It's got a naturally intimate atmosphere.
We feel that we are visiting a British monument while coming and having dinner here.
The menu is typically British.
It took my breath away, actually, when I came in. I couldn't believe that it was the same space.
We'll definitely be back for the cocktail.
Staff are very excited. They're buzzing, kitchen's buzzing, so good night. Good night.
Tomorrow night, copy-paste. Let's do it all again.
Transforming the most famous ship in the world into a modern hotel was never going to be easy. But despite the challenges and setbacks, the QE2 team have managed to pull it off. And this little bit of Britain in Dubai remains afloat.